Thank you for that wonderful introduction. Ano, may energy pa ba? Alright. Great. So, next slide, please. Okay. Actually, mag-storytelling lang ako. Okay? The energy engineering program of Mabua, as I mentioned a while ago, is the first Bachelor of Science in Energy Engineering in the Philippines. Okay? Now, one of the main goals of this program is to support our climate change dilemma. Okay? Yung mga problem natin sa climate change, global warming. So, ito yung program, a full bachelor's degree program to really develop the pathway papunta sa low carbon economy. Pag sinabi natin low carbon economy, as the image depicts, no, yung ating pagiging green or medyo mas environmental friendly technologies, yun yung ating mga ginagamit. Now, having said that, madaming magagawa ang mga kagaya nyo kung paano tayo mag-shift into dirty power or dirty energy, tsaka yung paggamit ng ating mga renewable energy. So, next slide. Now, why doesn't a traditional approach on energy is working? So, sabi natin, for the longest time, kung ano yung kailangan ng industry, gantong kalaking megawatt na power, so magtatayo ng power plant. Sa bahay nyo, di ba? Pagka magpapatayo kayo ng bahay, tapos na-estimate ng mga engineer kung ano yung power requirement, hindi kayo basta pwedeng maglagay ng maraming aircon, maraming ref, bukas yung electric pan kahit hindi ginagamit, bukas yung TV. So, ito yung mga sinasabi natin na in a global perspective or national perspective, hindi na umuubra yung ganong planning na approach. It should be a innovative approach na. Kasi kapag ginawa natin, yung kailangan ng energy ay mag-develop lang ng power plant, di hindi tayo tumitingin sa energy efficiency side or energy efficiency aspect, medyo hindi siya in the long term sustainable. That's why dapat ang pagpa-planning ng energy kahit sa bahay ay yung talagang medyo innovative na. That's why, next slide please. So, in energy program sa Mabua, we incorporate AI to energy. Now, ano ba ang use ng AI sa industry ngayon or sa sector? For example, aside from mga ChatGPT or yung mga Copilot or any generative AI, pwedeng pakinabangan ng isang AI technology to plan, to predict. So, yung prediction kung gaano kadami yung power plant, gaano kadami yung solar, yung wind, yung iba't ibang klaseng technology na ide-develop natin para siguradong yun yung kailanganin natin na magagamit. Ginagamitan na natin ang technology yan. So, yung mga AI initiatives or ginagamit namin sa school for education purposes are also used to be in the planning stage of a national energy plan. Now, sino ba ang dapat na mag-trigger ng change? Okay? Aside from the mga nag-manage to have this event today, for example, yung Mabua, the School of Mechanical Manufacturing and Energy Engineering, we also have the Department of Energy, the Presidential Communications Office. Pero ang mag-trigger ng change ay hindi mga policy makers or administrators kagaya namin. that would be you. Okay? Kayo ang mga change agent para ma-trigger yung adoption ng technology-driven planning sa energy. Just like in our school, those students are the ones who are really creating research or study how to utilize energy well, how to conserve energy, just like also, next slide please. Yung Bachelor's Energy Engineering program, also in our school, with mechanical, manufacturing, and other engineering programs, we are into innovation. Yung Shell Eco Car, or yung Shell Eco Marathon na sinalihan namin recently, was able to produce more than 200 kilometer per liter vehicle. At yung sasakyan na yon na kinumpit namin sa Indonesia, was able to give the Philippines an international award on the innovation from that competition. So these are the things na ginagawa ng Papua to support the energy engineering program. Now, as for you, high school students, senior high school, you can give something back to the environment as early as now. Okay? The utilization of energy, kung paano natin siya mas magagamit pa sa bahay, kayo yung mga magiging change agents. And of course, with the proper education on energy engineering, we can also tell you a story about how solar works, about how wind provides power for the whole island, yung pag-utilize natin ng hydroelectric power plant, and other renewable energy technologies. So, next slide. So with that, I'm going to end my presentation. And in Mapua, it's cool to be efficient. So thank you for listening for this centennial lecture series.
Hello, good morning to each and everyone. Thank you, Dean Calderon, for that energetic lecture. Okay, as you all know, Mapua will be celebrating its 100 years this coming January. And part of the celebration is what we call or dub as 100 Centennial Lectures. And Dean Aldrin Calderon is the number 88 of the Centennial Lecture. So as part of that activity, I would like to award this Certificate of Appreciation to Dr. Aldrin D. Calderon for imparting valuable insights to the Mapua community in the Centennial Lectures held on October 16, 2024 at the Mapua University Intramuros Campus, signed Dr. Doji S. Maestro Campo, President and CEO. Let's give him an energetic clap of hands. Thank you so much, sir.